In our ongoing study of the Word of God, we will now discuss end of days. Before we start, let's discuss what's happening this week with the Jewish people. This week, they're in fast mode. And I don't mean fast as in Speedy Gonzales. I mean fast as in fasting. And why are they fasting, you ask? Well, this week is Tisha B'Av. What? What the hell is Tisha B'Av? Well, I'll tell you what Tisha B'Av is all about. Tisha B'Av is the Jewish name for the 9th of Av. Now, what happened on the 9th of Av, you ask? Well, I'll tell you. That's the day when the first Jewish temple was destroyed. And it also happens to be the same day that the second temple in Israel was destroyed by the Romans in 70 AD. I was at the shul today, and they're all like, "Oh, the temple, we missed the temple, we miss it. I says, "Well, don't miss it too much, don't worry, there is coming another temple." That's all I can tell these people, because they're going to throw me out if I tell them there's going to be another temple after that. But now let me get to the bottom of the truth here. And there's these predictions that September 27 or some day like that, there is the signs and the stars, and we discussed that before, but let's continue here. The end of days cannot happen today, this month, this year, or in the next 7 years. I'm going to give you the logical answers for why the end of days cannot happen. First, we don't have the 10 kingdoms, and we don't have the Antichrist coming out of those kingdoms. So that's number one. Number two, there is no temple built in Israel for the Jewish people to start sacrificing, and then for Antichrist to set up his headquarters in it for the last 2.5 years. That's number two. Third, Babylon, the city, must become headquarters of great prosperity and a trading center. And right now, if you take a look at Google Maps, you'll see that it's just desert. So that must be rebuilt before the end of days, so God can finally destroy them completely. Okay, so let's recap so far. We got the Euro countries. We got too many countries in there. We got to bring that down to 10 rulers. Brexit is going to be the beginning, but then we still have a whole bunch of other countries that have to break up from the Euro and bring it basically down to 10 different governments. Okay? Then we have the Antichrist that's going to come up from them and is going to start making wars against everybody. Then let's talk about the temple in Jerusalem. That's not built yet. They're talking about it. They've got the furnishings for it, but yet nothing's been laid, and they haven't started sacrificing nothing. They got a couple, red heifers in the barn there, but nothing's happening just yet. So that has to happen. Okay? Then Babylon, the actual city, has to be rebuilt and become popular and become basically headquarters of trading and so forth. So that hasn't happened yet. So I don't know about you, but in my timeline, I don't see it happening. Okay? Not this year, not next year, and not in the 7 years. Minimum 7 years. Why you say 7 years? Well, before the events that must come in the end times, there must be a rapture. And until the rapture comes, okay, we cannot start that timeline. So, between you and me, just relax, read your Bibles, study your Bibles. If you have questions, we're here to answer them. We want to make sure that you are living in faith and that you are living with the truth. YouTube is nice, but YouTube is also brainwashing millions, if not billions, of people who think that this year is the end of times. And if you're one of those people that believe that this is the final year, that this is the year that the Messiah comes and takes care of business down here, well, email us your bank information so we can transfer all your funds into our funds so that we can propagate and spread our word with your funds, because right now we don't have any funds, and it would be fun to have some funds to reach the ends of the world before the end of the world. Thank you.